Well, good morning. Happy Monday, Manna. Excited to share God's word with you today, as I am every Monday. I know I say that every Monday, but I really am excited to share God's word with you. Today, it's found out of James chapter 1, verse 22. James chapter 1, verse 22, and it says, "Be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving yourself." And this is an incredible verse because it really does speak to the heart of how the Lord would want us to walk before him. You know, the scripture says here, don't be hearers of the word and not doers. You know, you can hear the word of God. We can be inundated with sermons and preaching and all kinds of things. We can read the word of God regularly. But the word of God will not produce fruit in your life until you become a doer of the word. The Bible says that you are deceiving yourself if you simply read. If you simply read the word, if you simply hear the word and you don't do the word, then you are deceiving yourself. You are in a place of deception. Why? Because the word of God's potency, its power comes in the activity of the word, in the action of the word, in the obedience of the word. When you operate in the obedience of God's word, that's where there's power. That's where there's the Christian walk. You are not truly a disciple of God until you do the word. You can hear the word, you can read the word, but until you do the word, you're deceiving yourself. You're not truly being a disciple. You're just simply gathering information. The word of God comes to life. The word of God becomes potent in your life. The word becomes transformational when you do the word, when you obey the word. And we don't obey the word 5%, 10%, 20%. We obey the word 100%. And the scripture says here, be doers of the word. Put your reading, put your listening, put your faith, as you might say, into action. Put it out into action. Begin to do the word. Begin to honor the word. Begin to let the word be the standard and the activity of your life. Begin to let that word be how you spread out your life. Do the word. Whatever the word says, you do it. The word says to forgive, you forgive. The word says to bless, you bless. The word says to stop sin, you stop sinning. The word says to pray, you pray. The word says to give generously, you give generously. The word says to invest, you invest. The word says whatever it says. Whatever the word is speaking to you, you do it. You be a doer of the word. You be an obedient child of the word. That's the only way you can truly be a child of God. The Bible says very clearly that my children know my voice. And the voice of a stranger, they will not follow. What does that mean? That means as children of God, we know his voice through his word, through his spirit. And then we follow that voice. There's an action that's attached to knowing his voice. There's an action that's attached to hearing his voice. I don't just hear it, I do it. Whatever he says, I act upon. See, a disciple is someone that's learning to be like Jesus, is learning to live out their life and act out their life the way Jesus did. Well, Jesus was all about action. Whatever the Father told him to do, he did. He told him to be baptized, he did. He told him to go and meet certain people, he did. He told him to get in the boat, he did. He told him to die on the cross, hello? He did. Whatever the word told him to do, Jesus did it. That's why he was perfect, because he perfectly obeyed the word of God. And you and I, if we want to be like him, we need to obey the word of God. We need to live 100% in his word. We need to be hearing his word and doing his word, not merely hearing. Because the Bible says that if you simply hear the word, you are deceiving yourself. You're lying to yourself. You're lying to yourself that you're a child of God. You're lying to yourself that you're growing in the word. You're lying to yourself that you're growing. It is all a lie. But if you're a doer of the word, then you are truly becoming a disciple. You cannot be a disciple of the Lord without obeying the word of God. They are synonymous. They go together. Obedience to the word means that I'm becoming a disciple. And so, Father, I pray, God, that you would bless us. Father, I pray that you would cause us, Lord God, to not simply be hearers of the word, but to be doers, Lord God, that what we hear, we put into practice. We act it out, Lord God. We live in it, Lord God. We obey it with 100% obedience, even if we don't understand it, Father, even if we don't agree with it, God, because we want to honor you and we want to be your disciples and we want to be your children. And Father, we don't want to be deceived. We don't want to deceive ourselves simply thinking that we're okay because we've read the word or we've heard the word. No, God. The only time we are becoming like you is when we're doing the word. So I pray, God, you give us obedience hearts, yielded hearts, Lord God. Hearts that will do your word without hesitation. And Father, we will not allow ourselves to be deceived by just simply reading. We'll know without a shadow of a doubt that as we do your word, we are becoming more like you. Give us 100% obedience in our life, God. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Well, have a great day, everybody. I'll see you tonight at our prayer meeting, tonight at 9:15. I'll see you guys. Also, if you want to know more about the ministry, go to MarshaMansour.com. You can see videos. There's brand new sermons up actually today. You can go see new sermons that are up today, different audio casts and different things like that. Also an opportunity for you to send us your prayer requests and an opportunity if you become a financial partner of the ministry or if you want to give an offering to the ministry, by all means, it would be so appreciated. Go to MarshaMansour.com and go to the covenant partner page and these all these different mechanisms that you can use to either give an offering or become a financial monthly supporter of the ministry. Love you all so much. Thank you for sharing with me today and being with me today. And I'll see you tonight at prayer at 9:15. Bye-bye.